Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Charles. I want to welcome you guys to the conversation. So today, we're going to be talking about Colin Kaepernick. I know it's a little bit different. We're usually used to doing basketball videos, but it's a sports channel. We got to talk about sports and you know, and different things that are happening in the sports world that I believe is moving the culture forward and moving the news forward. So today, I want to talk about Colin Kaepernick. Now, all of us know this story about Colin Kaepernick. For pretty much the past 3 years, ever since he took a knee for justice, he lost his job, he's been out of the NFL, he sort of turned into a political activist and a martyr in some people's eyes. And since then, there's been a lot of back and forth between him and the NFL. He's been very quiet, you know, tight-lipped about it. A lot of people have been sort of waiting to hear from him. He doesn't really speak much to the media. So you have a lot of people speaking on his behalf and, you know, they're telling his story for him. But just out of the blue, not too long ago, the NFL agreed to organize a practice where they would invite all the teams to a specific location where Colin Kaepernick can now go and showcase his abilities to see if he still has what it takes to play in the NFL. Now, from sources all around, you know, the league of the NFL, they say he's in phenomenal shape. He's been keeping in shape, but yet and still, he has to showcase his abilities. Now, we all know the history between Colin Kaepernick and the NFL and how, you know, they have a lot of bad blood. He doesn't really trust them. He feels like he was whiteballed to a certain extent. He lost his job for his political stance when he still felt like he was absolutely capable of being, you know, in the NFL. And a lot of people feel the same way. A lot of people say that he did not lose his job due to a lack of talent, but instead he lost it for his political stance. There's been a back and forth, but there hasn't been any hard evidence proving that there was collusion between the teams to say, hey, you know what, we're going to make a concerted effort to make sure that we keep Colin Kaepernick out of the league by, you know, via emails or phone calls or whatever it is. So it's sort of been a big hunch. You know, a lot of people suspected it, but there hasn't been any evidence to really pin it to and say, okay, this is the reason why. Here's the evidence. Here's the cold hard facts as to why Colin Kaepernick is not playing in the NFL. Fast forward to the present day. You know, the NFL agreed to, you know, organize an open practice or an open showcase where he can go out there and display his abilities in front of all the NFL teams. Now, obviously, they had certain stipulations within this agreement, whereas they wanted to use NFL cameras, NFL equipment. Colin Kaepernick was a bit, let me say, he had a lot of reservations about that because he wanted to bring in his own film crew, save it film it live and make sure he had the content, the raw footage, so that, you know, they wouldn't cut it and splice it in any kind of way to make it look like he underperformed in the practice run or whatever it was. So he went there and we all know what happened. He ended up moving the venue to a different place about 60 or 70 miles away from the original intended location. Due to that, I think only about 7 or 8 teams actually made it to the other location that he set, which I think was in a high school or high school football field. He went there, showcased his abilities, and then he sort of went off on a tirade, you know, where he was a bit abrasive, saying that, you know, I'm ready to play, stop running, we're here, my lawyer's here, and all of these different things. And it caused a lot of people to look at Colin Kaepernick and say, hey, man, wait a minute, what is your objective here? Is your objective to make it into the NFL? Because if it is, this isn't the best way from a diplomatic standpoint to get into the NFL. Because remember, yes, you're the wrong party, but you're still seeking employment from the NFL, which is a fair argument to make. And although they have reached a financial settlement between these two parties, I don't want to get into the nitty-gritty of these, you know, all those details. But yet and still, on that day, a lot of people said that it was, you know, Colin Kaepernick didn't come out on top on that particular day. And the NFL can say, hey, they can throw up their hands and say, hey, listen, we've done our due diligence. We had a practice run. We invited all the teams. There's something we've never done before. Now, granted, on the day in which they decided to hold a practice, I believe it was on a Saturday, general managers and, you know, head top assistant coaches would not be able to make it because obviously they're traveling to go play games on Sunday. So that also led to the skepticism that Colin Kaepernick had after the event, going into the event, and everything else that's transpired since. However, just a few days ago, I read an article from MSN Sports by Jesse Reed, which says basically that there are two teams that are interested in signing Colin Kaepernick, which sort of jumped out at me when I read it. So after appearing on the Adam Carolla show on Tuesday, Mark DeRagos, which is Colin Kaepernick's lawyer, spoke in depth about the reason why Colin Kaepernick workout was moved, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. He then went on to say that there are two teams that I think are in the hunt. One who is legitimately, who is in legitimate need of a quarterback and who has a very poor, and that had a very poor showing last Sunday, and has got an owner that doesn't give a bleep about the whole Colin Kaepernick situation. The second team, he said, is also a runner, you know, to get Colin Kaepernick, who also doesn't care, but which is in the hunt and desperately needs a quarterback. So what this seems to be is that, given all the hoopla and everything that's transpired since, because you got to remember, Colin Kaepernick has not played in the NFL for over 1,000 days, which is about 3 years. So for all of this to transpire over the weekend and all the things that happened, for him now to still have two teams to be interested in him, given, you know, out of the pool of 7 or 8 teams that attended to see him, you know, showcase his abilities at the high school, you know, it, for me, it was something that's quite surprising, because a lot of people after, you know, how he came out and spoke against the NFL after the practice run that he did, a lot of people were saying his chances are completely squashed. He will never get into the NFL. But according to his lawyer is saying that there are two teams that are interested in him. Now, I don't know if this means that Colin Kaepernick is going to get signed. However, I think it's an important development in this story, and that's what I want to know from you guys. So, what I want to know is, do you guys think that Colin Kaepernick eventually would get signed by one of these two teams that manager anonymously announced? Or do you think that that's it for him? We're not going to see Colin Kaepernick in the NFL forever and ever and ever. That's what I want to know from you guys. So leave a comment in the comment section below. I really want to know what you guys think about this topic. Again, we don't really focus too much on the NFL, but this is a quite easy story to be able to follow. And I definitely want to get, you know, sort of the pulse from what you guys think, you know, out there in the sports world. So just know what you guys think so we can, you know, start a conversation. Once again, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell to make sure you get all of our new content when it comes out. Once again, this is Charles here from DreamersPro. Wishing you guys an amazing day. Peace!